The first big shot in the federal election campaign has been fired in Adelaide. The government pledging a multi-million dollar rescue package for Australia's car makers. But as Alice Monfries reports, the Holden boss maintains the future of the Elizabeth plant remains uncertain.
Day one on the election trail, our struggling car manufacturing industry the first target. Federal Industry Minister Kim Carr in town to spruik a $200 million pledge to help keep local car makers afloat.
We can provide rebates to ensure that people are given a further incentive to buy Australian, and we want to see businesses buy Australian.
We support the Australian car manufacturing industry.
But it's not yet known how much of that funding will go to Holden. The announcement comes as the car maker's boss, Mike Devereux, also flew into Adelaide to try and convince the 1,700 remaining workers that a three-year wage freeze could help secure the Elizabeth plant. But any commitment on the long-term future of Holden will have to wait until after September 7.
Certainly we would need to wait until, frankly, the outcome of the election to be able to commit that billion-dollar investment.
A secret ballot for workers has been postponed from Friday to next Tuesday. The union says prolonging the vote just adds to the pressure on families.
The morale's down and workers are very, very concerned. They want to get on with their lives and so on. So the quicker the certainty is in regards to, you know, the new business plan, the quicker it is for these workers and their families.
The Premier also met with the Holden's boss today. He says however the federal government's $200 million package is carved up, it's better than the opposition's policy to refer future funding to the Productivity Commission and leave it to the market.
There's no doubt it will make a positive contribution. Anything that improves the relative attractiveness of locally made vehicles will lift vehicle sales.
And in some good news for the car making industry, last month's new car sales figures increased by almost 5%. Alice Monfries, 10 News.